I don't know yet. Think so, I'm sure I am.
Well, how about your country, man?
My weight? About 214. I will not say. I'll just give you one hint. No contest.
Well, Hammond, there's rumors around that you slow down in the latter part of the ring. Is this true or is it?
Yeah, I don't dance and move like I used to as much because mostly I was so far advanced for my age, I was fast and skillful, and I didn't hit as hard. My bones were, I'm 29 now, I'm just right. I either bruise or cut or knock out. When I hit now, after two or three rounds, something happens. I can wait around a while. I don't have to move as much as I used to.
You believe Joe is a slow starter?
No, I don't know. It's not that his fellows just tire out running and fighting. See, it takes a lot of strength to keep backing up and punching. Only myself and Sugar Ray were the only two known to be able to whoop a man and keep backing up for 15 if you had to. And me being a heavyweight is really unusual. And the fellows, even like Bobby Foster, was too heavy to fight at his pace. But I'm twice as fast as people like Ellis and Foster, and I can do it for 20 rounds if I had to. So he'll be slow all through the fight with me. But he looks fast. He looks better in the later rounds with his opponents because they always win the first two or three. He's easy to hit. Everybody hit him. They just can't keep hitting him. They tire out. They get tired of hitting him. Never fought a good, skillful, real great fighter. They could hit him for 20 rounds as long as keep hitting him. Get tired. He's going to get tired first if he's taking all the punishment. He tires quick. When he fought Bonavina, he was pooped, about to fall on his face. Barely got through the last two rounds. That's what I remember. I don't remember all this talk, beating light heavyweights and my sparring partners. I'm watching his two toughest fights, Oscar Bonavina and Jerry Quarry. Both gave him all hell. And I came back and whipped both of them easier than he did, been off 3 years, looking bad with Bonavina and come out unscratched when Bonavina beat his face to a pulp. That's what I noticed, not this stuff you be talking about in these cartoons you draw. I'm looking at the real stuff. It's his style. He's a homemade, easy. He's easy to fight. Patterson and Terrell would be rougher than him. He's easy to jab, easy to hit. His sparring partners, he fired the wrong sparring partner the other day. I got an informer in his camp. He fired the wrong man, but the real one is still there. And he ain't about but two left, and it's up to him to figure out who it is. Beautiful, but they had Yank Durham had to slow him blood. Blood just gushing from his nose. They had to stop it the other day. Huh? Just keep check on him. Why do spies go watch other ball teams and football teams? Just to get an idea on the progress. All I want to know is, do the sparring partners hit him every time they throw a shot, they hit him? That's all I need to know. As long as I can land, it's all over. Hitting him, beating him every day, punch everybody that watches him train, says no contest. You better not fight like that with Ali. They jab him, they hook him, they uppercut him with lefts and rights. They just keep his head going, and he comes in real bullying, and he keeps taking them. Needs a man that can keep it up, so in shape. Keep sticking and moving. And they don't fall whenever he's hit. Man, they can get hit and back off. See, Ellis and Foster, every time they got hit, they get up and walk right back into hitting range. Bonavina hit me harder than any man could hit me. He never knew it, neither did you, because I danced out of range. See, I don't stand still when I'm tagged. I dance. Time up, hold him, back up, stick it, move. Don't take but a few seconds to recuperate if you're in shape. Ellis kept running in the... Frazier said, what? Well, I guess anybody could if I keep letting them hit me there. But for him and his short arms to get to my body, he's got to get within hitting range to touch my body. And before he's going to be in my hitting range, before he's in my hitting range. See, I'm a scientific fight. I figure all this out. See, when I do that, he won't be in... When he's on the end of that, his punch is going to stop by right here. His inches, his reach is, what, 70... 3-2 and mine is 84. Yeah, well, he's got to be real fast. Because Sport Illustrated clocked it at 4/100 of a second. Pow! Quicker than I blink. Pow! And if you can slip that and get in on me and hit two, he deserves everything he gets. If he can get by that, and flip it. He's going to talk to me. He, ain't that some nerve? He's going to talk to me. That's going to be one heck of a talking night. Who? I am the talker. What you mean he's talking? He's going to predict that I'm going. I made all these fighters talk. He's going to predict I'm going before 10. If I don't watch it, he might try to steal my shuffle. He can't dance, so he can't sing a lick. Somebody told him he could sing. Can't sing a lick. Fred? Heck no. Me or Fred? Man, I've been to the boxing school. This looks rough to you all. I was on a plane coming here, and he hit some rough turbulence. And I was frightened, a jumbo jet. I was upstairs. I ran down. I went to the pilot, and I said, all right, can you go over it? He said, oh, we go through this all the time. This is light. These wings are made to span 17 feet. They're only going about 4 feet. He was conscious of it, so he wasn't worried. The unknown, it looks frightful to you fellas. You sitting at the typewriter, and you drinking every night, and you laying with your girlfriends. And boxing looks rough to you, but this is easy when you're in shape and young and good like I am. It ain't hard. Easy. Boxing is easy. I look at me. I don't get hit, cut, and bruised. I don't worry about nothing like that. This is just another night for me. The way you all build it up, Life magazine cover, Time magazine, everybody gives their opinion. Dempsey says I'll lose. Joe Louis, and when Joe Louis say I'm going to lose, I thought I knew I done won this one. So Joe Louis always picked the wrong man. Always picked the wrong. Where's Joe Louis at? Joe Louis is here tonight. Where's Joe at? Joe Louis. Joe Smart. Oh, I'm going to have a ball. I don't have to hold my guard up at Frazier. Frazier's not fast. No footwork. See, my defense is here. Not here. I don't block punches so like powders from the people. See, this is my defense. See, I'm out of range. I have a built-in radar. See, pop, I'm moving and dancing. And I know when I'm in hitting range. When I'm in hitting range, I might come up. But as long as I'm not in hitting range. Right, Burke Lancaster?
How do you compare?
Took Bert to the ghetto in Miami the other day. We went over to the black neighborhood, so I won't have no more trouble out of him. What you say? Romanian. Speak English, man. You tell them that I'm thankful that I have fans way over there in the country, and as soon as I get my passport with my domestic problems over, that's one of the countries I'm going to visit. I got a lot of letters from Romania.
How do you compare Frazier from your last fight?
Oh, thank you. Could you pitch it to me? Romanian doll. This is a... Who makes these dolls? America? Huh? Oh, Japan? Made in Japan? Oh, that's Western. That's Westernized, man. Anyway. Romania. No, don't have me holding no dolls, man. Got me holding dolls. They be calling me something. Win or lose, I don't even think about losing. Seriously, I never think about losing. I am serious. I don't even think about it. It's impossible for Frazier to outbox me, outclass me, whip me. If I win, well, I don't know. I can't say yet.
How do you
make
compare
no
Frazier with the last fight?
Frazier's easier than Bonavino. Bonavino was awkward. He stalked the ring. He didn't fight his regular style. Combination I've developed. A new something that I have developed called the ghetto whooping. The alley ghetto whooping.
Just listen to the noise of this crowd. This is well going to be a great evening for boxing fans all over the world. In a moment, we should be seeing Joe Frazier. In just a moment, I think we'll be seeing Joe Frazier. It is characteristic, as you know, for the challenger, which is the position that Muhammad Ali is in now, to come out first. Here comes Angelo Dundee through the ropes. Dr. Pacheco. These are the people that will be in the corner. Bundini Brown, who will be in the corner with the champ. Muhammad Ali in the ring. In a beautiful, beautiful red and white robe. Those of you who are looking at this in black and white, I must tell you that he is in a beautifully red-colored robe. Now here comes Joe Frazier. Joe Frazier will be here any minute. He's coming out. Listen to the roar of this crowd. I want to tell you, this is going to be a spectacular evening. The tension and the excitement here is monumental. Joe Frazier is on his way out. Archie, how does Muhammad Ali look to you, Archie?
Looks beautiful. He looks beautiful. He looks
very trimmed, isn't he?
Yes, he looks like he's mad. And I suppose he'll
Would you say he's psyched up? Here comes Joe Frazier. Here comes Joe Frazier, ladies and gentlemen. There seems to be a mingling of boos along with the applause. I don't know why. This man is a gallant champion.
Right, he is.
But that's the way fight fans are all over the world. Here comes Joe, and he is dressed in a beautiful green. Beautiful green. Right above me now is Yank Durham. Don, would you give us a few comments on the rules?
First, I will, Bert. Of course, they're wearing 8-ounce gloves. Here in the state of New York, we have the mandatory 8-count if a man is floored. The 3-knockdown rule is in effect. That is, if a man is floored 3 times in a round, he is automatically counted out. If he is floored at or near the bell, the count will continue at the bell except in the last round. We have a referee and 2 judges who will do the scoring, and the scoring is on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system if the rounds come out even. For the first time in heavyweight championship history, we have 2 undefeated fighters in there. Frazier has won all 26 of his bouts with 23 knockouts, and Muhammad Ali has won all 31 of his bouts with 25 knockouts.
Muhammad is clowning it up in the ring now. He's got a smile on his face. I think you saw that little brush that he had with Joe. Joe looks pretty mad about the whole thing. Let's hope that the boys don't begin to mix it before they get their robes off. What do you say, Archie, about that?
I think they are in tremendous condition.
Yeah, they both look swell.
Tremendous condition, and they're both eager to go.
Archie, tell me. Go ahead, Don. Do you want something you want to make say?
No, I think that Johnny Addie is about to introduce him, though, Bert. And Archie will be back to you in just a moment. Here's the famous ring announcer, Johnny Addie.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We also have here tonight undefeated retired heavyweight king, Gene Tunney. Take a bow, Gene Tunney.
Gene Tunney sitting in the audience, retired undefeated heavyweight
ladies
king.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are the ring officials assigned by the New York State Athletic Commission. The judges, Bill Recht and
Aidala.
Archie,
you were remarking a moment ago about the condition of these two fighters.
Fred, well, Bert, I believe that Frazier is in what you call fighting trim, and Ali has not been fighting regularly enough to be in the fighting trim. It's like, he's very much unlike...
Well, wouldn't you say, though, he's in good shape?
He's in good shape, no
but
doubt.
But you're making a difference between what you call fighting trim and good shape, is that
right,
it?
Right, right. You see, a man like George Foreman, who's been fighting right along under Dick Sally, is in fighting trim. You see, this is the way...
All right. All right.
He's wearing red trunks. He weighs 215, undefeated in 31 bouts, scoring 25 knockouts. Here is Muhammad Ali. His opponent from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, he's wearing green trunks. He weighs 205.5 pounds, undefeated in 26 bouts, scoring 23 knockouts, the heavyweight champion of the world, Joe Frazier.
Let's pick up the last-minute instructions from Arthur Mercante.
Since this contest is for the final determination of the heavyweight championship of the world, we ask you to pay particular attention to the rules of the New York State Athletic Commission. In the event of a knockdown, you must take an eight count. The other man must retire to the neutral corner. Three knockdowns in one round will automatically end the contest. Break when I tell you to break.
Dundee on the right. Nancy Durham on the left.
Shake hands now, man. Return to your corner. Hold it.
Almost ready for the fight of the century. Yancey Durham has a question. And now we're ready. Hundreds of millions are seeing this bout around the world. A packed house at Madison Square Garden. Muhammad Ali in the red trunks. Joe Frazier in the green trunks. They appear very light. Frazier will try to bore in and catch his man. Muhammad Ali opening up fast. He may try to blitz him here in round one. And he's trying it. Muhammad Ali may try a blitz. He got in that good left hook. Frazier is not the easy target he used to be. He's bobbing and weaving all the time. And he's dangerous. His best punch, the left hook. Muhammad Ali's best punch, the jab, and his good combinations.
All right, break, boys, break.
First clinch of the fight. That was a hard left hook that caught Frazier. Frazier is more vulnerable in the first round, and Muhammad Ali knows that. Shakes his head and is warned for holding behind the neck. Muhammad Ali has been missing. But that jab didn't miss. Muhammad Ali shakes his head as though his man was nothing, but he was tagged. A whipping left hook to the body that must have hurt by Frazier. Now Muhammad Ali is finding the mark with those jabs. And he gets caught on the ropes, which he should not do. 1 minute to go in round one. Frazier is smiling as he takes those jabs. Is not trying to make use of the ring. He's standing there with Frazier. And that's not considered healthy. Muhammad Ali, flat on his feet, not up on his toes, like the Muhammad Ali of old. Frazier just fights one way. He bores in and he punishes. 15 seconds to go in the round. It's been a fairly close round. Frazier getting closer to the ex-champion. The round is almost over.
Well, the round is over. Listen to the roar of that crowd. That is one of the most exciting first rounds I think we've seen in a long time. And Frazier really is unrelenting. He keeps moving in. He hasn't given Muhammad Ali any chance to move around and fight his own fight. It would seem to me that Frazier's making the fight. Wouldn't you say so?
I think that Frazier...
Watch this in slow motion at 135 seconds into the fight.
Done a good job of manhandling.
Joe is shaking his head, as you can see there, Muhammad Ali, as much as to indicate that he wasn't really hit hard.
That's a subterfuge, I believe, because he was hit very hard.
Here we go. We're ready now, almost at the beginning of round two. All right, Don Dunphy.
There's Joe Frazier in his corner with his manager, Yancey Durham. Champion Joe. Muhammad Ali. Round two. The Muhammad Ali that we remember of 3.5 years ago was a dancer. He's not dancing tonight. He may be trying to slug with Joe. Those are hard jabs and a good right cross. Frazier may have been hurt a little bit by that punch. Referee Arthur Mercante, a fine official, gets them apart. A good exchange. A whipping right hand that did Muhammad Ali no good. Now Muhammad Ali may have been shaken. It's a real pure six belt. Muhammad Ali got in the best exchange, a good 1-2, a moment or two ago, as you saw. Muhammad Ali is not keeping Joe Frazier away from him. However, he is scoring heavily. Round two is half over. Frazier has taken a good battering in this round.
Stop talking!
And the referee told them both to stop talking. They have time for that. Muhammad Ali is putt-shotting Frazier with that right hand and getting away with it. And Muhammad Ali may be a little tired. Less than a minute to go in this round. Frazier every so often digs that wicked left hook to the body. It has been a dandy. Ooh, that must have hurt. Frazier has been hit with solid right hands that would have felled an ordinary man. 15 seconds to go in the round. That was the best punch in the fight, that left hook.
Beautiful round. Ali exhibited magnificent skill and hard punching power. Much
very hard punching power. Watch it in the slow motion. Frazier with that left hook. That beautiful left hook. Now Ali comes back. There is no question that if Ali wins, he'll be beating Frazier at his own game, don't you think?
That's right.
Here is the instant replay again. Look at that right. Look at those rights. Those rights and lefts. Frazier is a strong man. He missed with a left hook that time.
Ali is quite capable of tying a man up and strong himself.
No, Frazier just spit some blood. He is bleeding inside the mouth. Round three.
Round three.
Two undefeated fighters. This fight so far ranks with the great ones. Again, the referee tells them to stop talking, and they sure are fighting.
All right, break for it.
Frazier is not getting that clean shot at the body that he did in the earlier round, in round two.
Break.
It's amazing that Frazier can stand up under that battering. And he is scoring himself. Now, Muhammad Ali's reflex is telling in his favor. He has been keeping Frazier away with his longer reach. It's a question, how many of those punches Frazier can take? These are big rounds for the ex-champion. Now Frazier is scoring. He said he would go to the body, and he is. Frazier making good use of that head on the inside. Half a minute to go in the round. Frazier must be hoping that Ali will punch himself out. They're in Ali's corner, and Ali is hurt.
That's the end of round three. Round three, and it looked for a moment that Muhammad Ali was hurt. This is a tremendous round. Really, really massive fighting. I mean, Ali really hit Joe with everything in the book in that particular round, but Frazier is relentless. He's relentless. A little man, but he's a Sherman tank, and he keeps moving in. And he's certainly making. They're looking at, we see it on slow motion now. There's that beautiful left hook which caught Muhammad Ali. And Ali looked tired by the end of that round. We're going to see now the last 10 seconds of the round, where Ali is on the ropes. Joe begins to really score with some of those beautiful shots to the body. There he hit him with a left to the jaw. Now he's going to move him. Right to the body now. And here we go for round number four.
Muhammad Ali in his corner. He gets up before the bell. Round four.
Four.
They're in Muhammad Ali's corner. Now they move out in the center. Muhammad Ali is scoring heavily, but he could get discouraged. He's hit this man with his Sunday punches. And Joe keeps coming in. Joe is taking a battering. Anybody else would have been on the floor. Muhammad Ali is piling up a tremendous amount of points. At this stage of the game, he is way ahead, no question. They're just above us. That whipping right uppercut, one of Ali's best punches. Neither one has ever fought a fighter of the caliber of the opponent tonight. No question of that. A minute to go in round four. Ali cornered on the ropes. Joe could be running out of steam too. That's still a good jab. Ali ducked into that punch instead of moving. Round almost over. Archie,
he did. Frazier hit him with a tremendous hit. Tremendous punch.
A great round. The first part of the round was all Muhammad Ali, but Frazier kept pouring in relentless. Ray kept pouring right in. Then we're going to see it at 2:45 at the end of the round. 2:45 into the end of the round. Now look at Ali hit those blows, but look at Frazier keep coming. Now this is 35 seconds into the round. Now we're getting ready for round number five. Don Dunphy.
All right, Bert and Archie. Round five.
Round five.
Muhammad Ali may have been told to move more. He's up on his toes for the first time tonight, but he was tagged. Muhammad Ali dancing around for the first time. But Frazier has caught him again. Frazier says, come on in and fight. You know, Frazier also has a good jab. Muhammad Ali slipped there over in Frazier's corner. It's very wet, apparently. Always is in a fighter's corner. Muhammad Ali gets his right hand behind the neck and pulls Frazier in on him once in a while. Good 1-2 and a jab. Now Frazier is mimicking Ali. He's just smiling at him. If anybody is psyched here, it is not Joe Frazier. Look at that hook. Frazier is just laughing at him, talking to him. You know, that's the way Muhammad Ali used to taunt his opponents. Half a minute to go in the round. Bert Lancaster said that Joe Frazier was like a tank. That's just what he is. He just can't keep sticking that chin out, though.
What a round. I don't know how, though. I don't know how he can stand this. There we are watching it now. Look at him. See him taunt him in that one. He's dropping his hands and just letting him throw punches. I don't think, however, that Frazier can continue to take those kind of punches. But he surely is some kind of a very strong, strong man.
I think he's trying to psych him out, don't you?
Well, it sure looks that way. I mean, this is a Joe Frazier who's apparently kept a lot of anger against Muhammad Ali in his heart. And now he's really going to make a play. Here we are, 40 seconds into the round.
Here is round six, and this is
round
the round Ali said he would win in. Round six, the round. Now it's Muhammad Ali making the clinches. Frazier is trying to end it with one punch. Muhammad Ali had the fun, but Frazier landed the punch. Now it's Frazier doing the pot shotting as Muhammad Ali tries to hold on. 2 minutes left in the round. It is going to be interesting in the scoring. Frazier is the aggressor, and that will count for him. Half the round is over. One minute to go in the round. I get the feeling that they're both tiring a little bit. Ali almost a sitting duck here. Frazier has to rest a moment. The round is almost over. Ali will score no knockout in this round.
That's the end of the round. There's no question about it. Joe Frazier is absolutely relentless. He's coming in there. We're going to show you 20 seconds into the round, the slow motion. Watch Joe Frazier, just relentless, pouring it on in there. Ali tried to move around, but he's not going to be able to move around like of old. Look at that again. He's just in there. Joe is just murder. Just murder. He is one of the toughest men you'll ever see. This is 2:25 now into the round. This is near the end, and Ali is shaking his head.
This is when a man tries desperately to rally.
Ali's trying to hold him off with cute little tricks, but it doesn't work. There's the buzzer for round seven.
Muhammad Ali being talked to by Bondini.
Round seven.
A And Ali is caught on the ropes again, but this time he ties up his man. Ali shook his head as though to say it didn't hurt, but it must have. Frazier smiling again. I asked Archie Moore between rounds if maybe Frazier was punching himself out. Archie said he didn't think so. It has got to be maybe the most torrid heavyweight championship fight of all time. Again, Arthur Mercante tells Ali not to get that hand behind the neck. Wicked body punches by Frazier in Ali's corner. Round seven, half over. One minute to go in this round. Ali scoring with those solid jabs. And Frazier may have slowed down a little bit, but he dug one into the body. And Arthur Mercante tells Frazier to keep his punches up, which he just did. It's Ali dropping the hands. Frazier smartly goes for the body there. Well for Ali that missed. That didn't. Ali shakes his head. The round is almost over.
Round seven is over. Ali seems a little disgusted with himself, but he's mighty tired. I'd say he's having a tough time handling Frazier. Wouldn't you, Archie?
I think he's running out of his steam.
Here we come, 2:30 in the round, to show you that slow motion again. Now watch Frazier. Ali misses with a right, as you can see. And a left. Frazier is in there.
Joe says, come on out and fight. The bell hasn't sounded. There it is, round eight.
Round eight.
Both men in splendid condition, no question. Great athletes. Joe Frazier just literally took charge there. Now Muhammad Ali is piling up points with those jabs. Don't forget that. Joe looks like he's in a training session. Frazier is just pouring everything in there now. They're short punches, but punishing punches. Ali is making very little return here, and the crowd is getting on him. Ali is still talking, but he is also catching. Waving Frazier on. I don't know anyone who gets the sheer joy of combat the way Joe Frazier does. Some are landing on elbows, but some are getting in. Here it comes, look out. There it is. Half a minute to go. Round 8 of a 15 rounder, no knockdowns. Those pity pat punches aren't going to do much for anybody.
Archie, what do you think of this?
I think that Ali has tired out, and he has tried to psych Joe out by pretending
so
Joe wasn't hurting him.
I think so, too. I think he's taking quite a whipping.
I think he'll fight desperately in the coming round.
Well, there he is. There we are. There we are in slow motion, 30 seconds into the round. Now watch Joe. I don't see how this fight can go the distance. But like you say, these boys are in marvelous physical condition.
Fellas, the crowd has changed. Now they're yelling. Before they were yelling Ali, Ali. Now they're yelling Joe, Joe.
I know it. I don't see it going the distance. Do you, the way it's going now?
Well, I don't know. They've gone through 8 rounds, Bert.
That's true, but I mean, it's something, boy.
They could both punch out. You know, that's possible, Bert. Joe Frazier's corner, Yancey Durham, setting him up for the next round. Muhammad Ali, Frazier is the fresher of the two, no question. Round 9 of a 15-rounder. You must remember this in the scoring. Muhammad Ali has been making most of the clinches, and that will count against him. He has broken off the exchanges more often than not. He has also scored some devastating punches against Joe's head. Remember, against Oscar Bonavina, Muhammad Ali had enough left in the 15th round to score a knockout. Joe bobbing and weaving, trying to get that whipping left at the head. 2 minutes to go in this round. Frazier coasting a moment. Got him on the ropes above us.
Right,
now
back,
Frazier
Joe.
Is starting to relax and rest on the inside.
All right, Brooks, step back.
Frazier's trying to get that left hook to the head and takes punches in return.
Come on, man. Come on.
Frazier trying to get that guard down. Ali covering up on the ropes. That was a wicked punch. So was that. real trouble now. Judging by his looks, he's throwing out wild right hands. And Muhammad Ali comes back. He's got a great reserve.
Desperation round. Use a desperation round.
There we are. Here we are with the slow motion. Look at Ali go. Look at him go. Look at him. As Archie said, it's a desperation round.
Joe seems to be a little tired now. And
yes,
Ali,
I thought Joe looked a little tired.
Being refreshed. Ali's becoming refreshed.
Did you think so, Don?
I think Muhammad Ali summoned great reserve and just when he seemed to be going out, maybe.
Right. What a fight. What a pace. I've never seen a pace like this. Archie, have you ever seen a faster type of fight than
no,
this?
No, never, never. This is a beautiful thing. The only man could do this thing was Henry Armstrong.
You heard that? Only Henry Armstrong could keep this kind of pace. But two big heavy boys like this is quite remarkable.
Round 10. It's scheduled for 15. Now, let's see how that punishment affected Joe Frazier. He's probably been told to stay in close now to nullify that long-range hitting of Muhammad Ali. We'll see who got the most benefit out of a minute's rest. I don't think you'll see Frazier stay out in the center again and then just trade. He'll try to keep him on the ropes. Frazier grunting as he comes in with those punches. Frazier is putting everything into his punches. And now Ali looks tired again, but that could be deceitful. Looks like he wound up with that uppercut. Frazier trying to get Muhammad Ali to the ropes again. He takes punishment as he gets him there. What's going on here? Frazier may have something wrong with his eyes. He was calling his trainer in there. Frazier may have something in his eye. Muhammad Ali's coming at him now. But Frazier's trying to nullify it. For a moment, I thought Joe was going to walk out of the ring. Frazier taking that battering again. Half a minute to go in the round.
Another great round, and another good round, incidentally, for Ali. I mean, Ali seems to be coming back in a kind of a way. He came in with some beautiful combinations then. There was a peculiar thing happened there when Joe looked to his corner as though something was wrong, and the referee waved them on. Here we are, 125 into the round that you just saw. And now we're looking at it in slow motion. We're trying to find out what it was that was wrong with Frazier before when he made that gesture toward his corner. This is 2:20 in the round now. 2:20 and 2 minutes and 20 seconds into the round. And here's the buzzer for round 11.
Round 11. No knockdown. No knockdown. Muhammad Ali slipped down that time.
Step back. Come on. Great.
I'd say they're both pretty tired. There are 2 minutes left in round 11. Muhammad Ali holds on, but Joe's not rushing in there either. He's holding too. Trying to get that shot in there. Ali, Muhammad talks to him again. Not much happening, I'll say. Has gotten wild. He's lost the good timing he had earlier. Lost the rhythm. That one hurt. So did that. Muhammad Ali staggers. Muhammad Ali was blocked. He's holding on desperately. Thirty seconds to go on the round. Muhammad Ali and real trouble. Muhammad Ali rocks over the ropes. He almost went down. Ten seconds. The round is over.
What a round. Muhammad Ali was really out that time. Frazier really clobbered him with everything in the book.
Now, Bertie might try to fool him in this round. Next turn coming up.
I know, but I mean, he took a terrific beating. There was no question about it.
He may try to fool him and catch us.
Here we are, going to show it to you on slow motion again. Now, look at this.
Muhammad Ali's corner. But I guess he's all right. Angelo Dundee berated him. Berated his man between rounds. Round 12.
Round 12.
Frazier out there quickly. Well, who thought it would go this far? Muhammad Ali gamely trying to fight back, but he is spent. And Joe Frazier is pretty spent too. A wicked punch. Joe smartly goes for the body. Frazier resting in there too. He's had a tough night. 2 minutes to go in the round. Frazier is very tired himself. Frazier is getting in some wicked body licks. They're both tired. Why not after that pace? Muhammad Ali is missing a lot of those punches. Frazier laughs at him again. One minute to go in the round. Round 12. It could be a tough fight to score. Half a minute to go in the round. Round almost over.
That's the end of the 12th round. And Archie, that was a tremendous round.
Yes, it was.
Ali made a great comeback, didn't he, there?
Yes, but Frazier had him on the ropes. On the last and the last had him on the ropes.
From someone who was virtually out on his feet in the round before, I would say that Ali made a great comeback, but he's a tired boy. He's a tired boy. They were really working furiously in this corner, pouring ice in him. Now we're seeing an instant replay. 30 seconds into the fight, into this particular round. Ali is certainly disproving any doubt that he's not a game fighter.
Yeah, Frazier's been doing awful magnificent body work in here.
And now we see it, we see the same action in slow motion. We're coming up for round 13 now. There's the bell.
Round 13 of a 15 rounder.
Step back.
Step. Ali is putting all his power in those punches, and they've got to be hurting Joe. The biggest crown in the world at stake, the heavyweight championship. And Ali seems to be coming back. Now Ali is piling up points. He's boxing beautifully at the moment for a tired man. Ali slipped, but nothing happened over there. 2 minutes to go in the round. Frazier let him get away after that big 11th round. And that left hook hurt by Frazier. Oh, do you hear that punch? Ali making the clinches again. They're both great game fighters. There's a spot of blood on the shoulder of Ali. I guess it's from Frazier, but I don't see where. Well, they're fighting like lightweights now. The tide turns the other way now. If Frazier stays on top of Ali, Ali has no punching room. It's almost over this round. There's the bell.
Round is over. Round 13 is over. And what a round. I mean, that Joe Frazier's got to be some kind of a man. Ali hit him with every combination he could think of. Not once, not twice, not three times, not four times, but five or six times.
Ali's a very tired man.
And yet Ali wound up as being a very tired one. Joe just relentlessly keeps going. He has more stamina and power than anybody I think I've ever seen. Don't you, Archie?
I think so. He's sitting there hunched over his stool, ready to go out again.
There they are on the ropes just above us, Al. You're watching them in slow motion. Look at that left to Ali's jaw.
Of a 15 rounder. Joe Frazier is barreling in there now to keep Muhammad Ali from getting set. Wicked punches by the ex-champion. But there's Muhammad Ali caught on the ropes again. No damage that time. Two minutes to go in this round.
Okay, step back.
Step back, says the referee, Arthur Mercante.
Stop holding, boys.
Stop holding, says the referee. Muhammad Ali is doing the holding. He's also stalling for time. Joe Frazier wild with that punch. Remember, in the scoring, Muhammad Ali has made most of the clinches. For what that is worth. But he's dealing out plenty of punishment to Frazier as well. Frazier is very puffed around the eyes. He's got swelling around both eyes from those tremendous jabs and hooks. Frazier's right eye looks as though it might be closing. Hit. Frazier talks to him again there. This round nearly over. Round 14. No knockdowns, but Muhammad Ali was staggered in the 11th and almost went down.
That's the end of round 14, and what another great round it was. Now, if you look over at Joe's corner, there's something wrong with his face. He might very well have a broken jaw. I mean, he's got a welt there that's of enormous size. Now let's turn back to the instant play for a minute 35 in. Ali came through very well in this round, scoring repeatedly and seeming to get stronger. For a man who was virtually out in round 11, he's come back amazingly. These boys are in magnificent physical shape. Don't you think so, Archie?
Joe, I think so. I think that Muhammad Ali has proven a lot to a lot of people that he could come back.
That's right, that he could come back because he's fighting a really relentless fighter.
Joe has a serious welt.
Rubbing his leg.
Now we're going to look at it slow motion. All right, this is the final round of the fight, and what a fight it's been.
15 and final round.
Referee Arthur Mercante has them touch gloves, something they've been doing all night. Now, Muhammad Ali's gonna go boxing again. And Frazier gets in to nullify that attack. Step back, says the referee. Time is important here. Muhammad Ali was flat on his back, but he's a well-conditioned athlete. However, he is real tired. Frazier smartly goes for the body when Muhammad Ali covers up. 2 minutes to go in the fight. 2 minutes. To say is in a bedlam. Oh, what a shot! If Joe had followed that up, he would have finished it. Muhammad Ali has never taken such a battering. Frazier is just pot-shotting him now. One minute left. Look for a last-minute flurry by Muhammad Ali. Less than a minute to go. Muhammad Ali gamely fights back. And Ali again makes the clinch. Remember, the scoring is on a rounds basis. Frazier is tired, and his eyes are closing. Half a minute to go. Frazier has won the big rounds, the 11th and the 15th, at least up to now. Frazier has the man in the corner. 10 seconds. 5 seconds. We'll have an interview with the winner and maybe with the loser. There it is.
Round is over.
Great fight.
They're going to show you that knockdown again. They're going to show you that knockdown again.
decision by the two judges and the referee.
There's bedlam in the ring here, Mitchell.
Scoring on a rounds basis with a supplementary point system where the rounds come out even. Joe Frazier seems to be sick in his corner. He is worn out.
We're waiting for the decision.
Johnny Addie is collecting the cards from the officials. And the ring is starting to cloud up despite the security measures taken. The people are coming in the ring. And this was not supposed to happen.
We're going to show you the knockdown again.
Ladies and gentlemen,
here comes the decision. Johnny Addie.
Referee Arthur Mercante scores it 8-6, one even for Frazier.
One vote for Joe Frazier.
Addie Aidala, 9-6 for Frazier.
Frazier is the winner. Frazier is the winner.
Correct. 11 rounds for Frazier, 4 rally. The winner by unanimous decision, and still champion of the world, Joe Frazier.
For the first time in his career, Muhammad Ali was beaten. Archie Moore and Burt Lancaster are trying to get him over here.
Joe Frazier.
Burt, can you get him over? Joe Frazier is so spent that he wants to go out of the ring. He has just scored the greatest victory of his career, of anybody's career. Here comes Frazier over here, we hope.
I think Joe Frazier seems to be very hurt.
He is very spent, Bert. And if he doesn't want to be interviewed, I don't blame him.
He just doesn't want to be interviewed. He wants to get out to his room. Maybe we can talk to Joe later in the dressing room. Right now, he's a tired young man. He's the champion. He's won again.
Come on over here, Joe.
Congratulations, Joe.
Joe is going over to talk to Muhammad Ali. This is a wild scene here in the ring. We're trying to keep up with the action.
Come on, let's clear the ring, please. Please, everyone out of the ring.
Everybody out of the pool, they're yelling. Muhammad Ali and Joe Frazier.
And once again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you again for the fastest of all transportation.
You said to everybody that you really could take it and you could dish it out because it was a magnificent effort on your part. Best of luck to you now. We just had a word with Muhammad Ali. He says he thinks that he won the fight and got the decision. Be that as it may, he proved that he's a great champion. And he proved beyond a shadow of a doubt that he could take tremendous punishment and come back fighting.
This is a wild scene, Bert. Did you ever have one like this
no,
in the movies?
I talked to a very subdued Muhammad Ali. He indicated to me that he thought he won the fight, but he was very tired and very spent. I think both men took such punishment, I don't know how they withstood it.
I think that if Frazier had had anything left, he certainly would have knocked him out. But Frazier himself took an awful beating, you know. And it was a fine fight, no doubt about it.
Well, there's no question that Muhammad has proven something that people wondered about for a long time, whether or not he could take any punishment.
Oh, he took it, and he's game. There's no geezer in him, Bert, nor in Frazier. I think in the final analysis, what might have influenced the officials was the holding tactics by Muhammad Ali. Aggressiveness scores a big part here in New York State, you know, Bert.
I see.
However, I'm only guessing. Archie, how do you think they arrived at the decision?
Well, Don, I thought that it was very close indeed, but, I mean, the round that Frazier won were big, were monumentous.
He won the big rounds.
He did that.
And then the knockdown counted.
Right, we're going to show the knockdown again in slow motion in round 15. Now, if you look down below, you'll see it. There's the blow that had sent him to the ground.
That left hook.
Right to the canvas.
Somebody got a good picture there, Bert. See that flash?
Yes.
Ali has to be one of the greatest fighters of all time.
I want to tell you that it's pretty much of a madhouse right here. But so far, the police are... We're going to replay it again and show it to you again. There it goes, that left hook. Look at it. A tremendous left hook. Up to that point, Ali had made a strong comeback. There he goes down on his back. He made a strong comeback from his knockdown on the left.
There's Muhammad Ali being led out of the ring.
He's being booed. I don't understand why he's being booed. He fought like a great fighter, like only a great fighter could. Both of them did. And even though he lost...
Bertie's being booed because some people are front runners.
If he
had won the fight, they'd be cheering him.
I think probably you're right.
Right, Archie?
But he really proved he could take a punch.
Muhammad Ali's gameness has never been in doubt.
He fought a relentless man. There we are looking at the...
Frank
knocked
Morris.
Out again, and immediately he's up on his feet.
Frank
indicating the kind of courage he has.
He's a real tough man, too.
Well, I'm going to try to get Frank Morris over here. Frank, here is a...
You know, Archie, we said earlier today when we were...
Bert, if I may interrupt. This is Frank Morris, the chief deputy of the New York State Athletic Commission, the man in charge of all the goings-on here. You know Bert and Archie, of course. Frank, how do you think... You saw the cards of the two officials. How do you think they arrived at their decision, Frank?
Well, I'm off the record.
Off the record? We're talking to a couple of hundred million people.
Good, all right, but I'm saying the decision I thought was good.
Oh, we're not questioning that. No. I just want to know how they arrived at it. Do you think Muhammad Ali's holding or Frazier's aggressiveness?
I think, well, the referee had an 8-6-1.
That's close.
Pretty close.
Close.
Yeah, the fight was fairly close, with the exception of a few rounds where Frazier went to town.
Thank you very much, Frank.
I had the first two cards, but it was unanimous on all three, wasn't it?
Unanimous on all three. 8-6-1. 9-6, 11-4.
I think, John, that the fans really got their money's worth.
Oh, did they ever, Archie?
Great fight.
Did they ever?
One of the great fights of all time. I mean, he was hurt and he came back like a champ.
Twice.
Really did. Yeah.
Oh,
a
plenty game, both of them.
I always wondered whether or not he could take a punch. He proved it tonight, don't you think?
He surely did.
And fight back.
He surely did.
And fight back.
He fought back. He came back. He did a great job, I think.
That's right. What do you say, Jack? It's really great job. There we are, our relentless people here on the TV show. Keep showing the punch. There it goes. The same left hook. The same left hook. And down goes Ali. Down goes Ali.
But you notice that every time an opponent falls from the left hook, they fall the same way. The Bob Foster, Jimmy Ellis, and now Muhammad Ali.
Right.
They fell the same way.
Right straight back.
Straight back, yes.
Now, why is that, Archie? What is the significance of that?
I don't know. I think that is the way the leg crumbles. The leg crumbles.
Also moving away from the punch a little, don't you think so?
Right,
because he throws that left hook moving forward.
I think so.
Arthur, let me say that you did a marvelous job, as you always do.
Johnny Addie.
300 million people. I'm Johnny, rather. 300 million people are looking at you. Wouldn't you know it, I'd get your name wrong.
Well, it's nice to work with you and the champ here, Archie Moore, because Don and I are old friends. We've been working together 23 years.
I sometimes think that Don sleeps here under the ring.
It was a sensational fight for heavyweights.
Sensational. What a pace.
Yeah,
you realize how spent they were, both of those.
You know, heavyweights...
The pace was beautiful.
Archie, I can only recall one heavyweight championship fight, which didn't go this far, one half as far, that was as fast. And that was your fight with Rocky Marciano. And that was the fastest heavyweight championship fight till now.
For what, seven rounds, was it? Huh?
Nine.
Oh, yes. And you were marvelous up to the time you got knocked out, if you'll forgive me for saying so.
You
truly were. Well, here we are in Madison Square Garden. The people are still standing around. Nobody seems to want to go home. I think everybody has been treated to one of the greatest fighting evenings they've ever seen. The crowd is getting to be very orderly now. They're quieting down. For a while there, they looked like we were going to tear the place up. But these stalwart men of New York, New York's finest, were there to take care of things, and they did a marvelous job.
Bert, I'll say that regardless of whom they favored, the crowd took the decision very, very well. Naturally, there will be some who are very unhappy about it, as there will be some who are mighty enthused about it, but the great majority took it in stride.
Well, you know, there's something interesting. This fight was advertised as a battle of titans,
yes,
as a battle of giants. And we all know how easy it is to promote these things advertising-wise, and invariably it turns out to be some kind of a disappointment. But I may not be the most representative or knowledgeable man about boxing or fighting, but certainly in my lifetime I have never seen two people fight a harder fight, and give of themselves as much as these two men did tonight. I've never seen a heavyweight fight pace this fast or go this far. I've never seen such punishment dished out. I've never seen two men take it like they've done. They're a great credit to boxing, both of them. And Muhammad Ali once again proved, even in defeat, that he's a truly great fighter.
It's ironic, Bert, that the two Ali brothers lost their fights tonight.
Bert and Archie,
yes.
I think the decisive moments of the fight and what won the fight for Joe Frazier, kept his title for him, were the 11th round when he staggered Muhammad Ali into the ropes, and
badly.
Of course the 15th round.
That's
the
right.
Other rounds were pretty close most of the way, I
touch
thought.
Touch and go. Do you think, Don, in your estimation, that this will lead to a rematch, assuming that the boys would want one?
There have been intimations that Joe Frazier's pilot would want him to retire, but I don't know why. Certainly there should be a rematch. There's no question that each went out 110% to win this fight, and boxing will demand a rematch, I think.
I would think so.
And I think Gentleman Joe, he is a gentleman, will give Muhammad Ali a rematch. Don't you, Artie?
I think so. I think very much so. Yes.
Not to mention the million or so he'll get for doing it.
Of course.
There goes that knockout. That knockdown, I should say.
It was a beautiful executed blow.
Beautifully executed blow. That's right.
I wonder, Archie and Bert, you're both men of the world, if I may use the expression, what will this do to Muhammad Ali psychologically, now that he knows that he no longer is the greatest? How will this affect his temperament, I wonder?
I believe, Don, that he will go into the gymnasium or into the hills and condition himself, and he will probably fight the small exhibitions like he probably was advised to, and get himself in fighting trim. That was the difference between condition and fighting trim. That what I tried to explain to you before.
Archie, I meant, how about psychologically? How will this affect him?
Well, may I say that,
go ahead,
in my
Bert.
Opinion, if Ali decides at all that he wants to continue fighting, I think this will have a very sobering effect on him. One of the things that came out tonight was the fact that he's a man of enormous courage, that he was able to stand toe-to-toe with an invincible kind of a fighter and fight him at his own game, and in many, many instances, in many moments, successfully. I don't think that he will be the kind of clowning person he was before. That is assuming he intends to fight at all. It may be that he might decide at this point that he doesn't want to fight anymore. And there may be other things in life that may interest him. Also, as you well know, and as we all are aware of, his case is pending before the United States Supreme Court, and there's no telling what will happen to him. It may possibly be that he will be convicted by the court, as he's already been. He's on appeal now, and go on to jail. That would, of course, affect anything he would have to do.
Definitely.
But assuming that the Supreme Court upheld his position, and there are many people who feel that it might, and he wants to fight, I think that he would go back. I think he has indicated that he has the kind of courage and will to go back and say, I'm going to prove I can beat that man. That would be my feeling.
Bert and Archie, we've talked about Muhammad Ali. I'd like to say about Joe Frazier. Archie, you as a great champion could comment on this. I think if they fight again, that Frazier is not going to take the punishment that he took. I thought many times he took unnecessary punishment from Muhammad Ali. He just stood there and let Muhammad Ali hit him, which of course is silly. What do you think, Archie?
Don, I believe that he was trying to psychologically break down the barrier, the psychic barrier that Muhammad Ali had, because showing that he couldn't hurt him.
But I think he overdid it.
Yes,
I think so, too.
He was a very tired and weary, spent man. I would think that only his great will and determination kept him up. Yes. Well, I think we've talked enough. And I think now is the time for us to wrap this show up, as we say.
It has been a good evening.
Oh, it's been a wonderful evening.
We're going to show you once more in slow motion the knockdown. Our camera crews are in love with that big left hook, and they would like us to keep talking while they can go on for the next 28 hours showing the left hook. But I think the whole world has seen it. I want to say that we have once again seen an absolutely great fight between two great fighters and truly two men of great character. And the very fact that it went the limit is a proof of the kind of endurance and courage that these men had. Because either one of them, if they didn't have that kind of character, could have been knocked out somewhere in the early rounds.
Right.
Joe Frazier was a very tired young man. Even though he won the championship, he was so tired he just wanted to get into his dressing room and not talk to anybody. Muhammad Ali did say a few words for the audience, but he was also a very whipped young man, rather dazed, and very, very quiet. None of the gregariousness or the overtness of the Ali of the past.
I'm not
getting we
anything.
Saw a great fight tonight, one that will really go down in history. And I think you saw a great fight too. So with that, I will say goodnight to you, Archie, and to you, Don, and to all you lovely people all over the world.
Thank you, Brad.
You know, just to dwell on it once moment more, fellas, if you picked up the papers tomorrow, if you didn't see the fight and you saw Joe Frazier won a unanimous decision, you might think it was a nothing fight, and it was far from that.
Yes, right.
Because it was so close.
That's right.
So, on behalf of my wonderful, wonderful colleagues, great screen star Burt Lancaster, great light heavyweight champion Archie Moore, this is Don Dunphy in the ring at Madison Square Garden saying, it's been a wonderful evening. Good night.